Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about design of a welded plate grinder. So this is useful for engineering students, so which is a essay type question in design of steel structures. So the given question is, span is 24 meters and the live load is 35 kN per meter. So here we are not using stiffeners, end and intermediate stiffeners, and the steel is Fe415 E250 steel. Actually, these type of plate girders are used in bridges. So first, the given span is 24 meters and live load is 35. For this, the factor load is 35 into 1.5, nothing but a factor of safety. So 52.5 kN per meter. And the self weight is W by 200. So this W by 200 is the formula which is developed by, practically developed, which is nothing but empirical formula. So this value we need to remember. So W by 200. So 52.5 into 24 is the span divided by 200. So I got 6.3. So total factor load is 52.5 plus 6.3. So I got 58.8 kN per meter. And the next bending moment, M equal to, you know the formula, WL square by 8. So I got 42,336 kN meter. And next shear force is WL by 2, we know the formula. So W value is, we know that 58.8 into L is 24 by 2. I got 7,056 kN. So next we need to find out depth of the web plate. So by using this formula, that is K equal to D by TW less than or equal to 67, which is specified in IS 800-2007. Available in page number 59, you can refer. So economical depth of the web, D equal to MK by F by power 1 by 3. So by using this formula, I'm going to find out D value. So M is nothing but moment, already we know the value. And next, into 67, which is the code specifying this class, by 250. 250 is yield stress. So I got D equal to 1043 mm. So after calculating the D value, I'm taking, I got 1043 mm and I'm considering this as 1000 mm plates. Okay. After that, we need to calculate thickness of the web. So thickness of the web is nothing but 1000 by 67. So here already I show you the formula 67. So thickness of the web we need. So 1000 divided by 67, I got 14.92. So here I am taking TW as 16 mm thickness of the web. So web plate selected, which we are going to select the web plate, that is 1000 mm by 16 mm size. Next, after selection of web plate, we need to select flange. So here this is I section. Have you seen this? This is the web portion and these two are flanges. And now selection of flange. The formula is M equal to area of the flange yield stress into D by gamma M naught. Okay, so M value we know that, and we need AF, that is area of the flange required, and F wave is yield stress value, that is 250, and D is 1000, which we provided. And gamma M naught is nothing but 1.1, that is partial safety factor of that material, which is available in table number 5, page number 30. So after calculating this, I got 18628 mm square. Next, by referring table 2 in page number 18, the code is specifying that whether the section is plastic or semi-plastic or compact, like that. So by using these values in table number 2, B by T suffix F less than or equal to 8.4. here we are having two flanges, so I wrote it as 2 B by 2 into thickness of the flange less than 8.4. so after that, I am solving this equation, B suffix F equal to 16.8 into T suffix F. So area of the flange. So area of the flange is nothing but, this is the flange portion, I'll show you. So this is the flange portion. Area of this rectangular portion formula is L into B. So here L is nothing but B suffix F into thickness of the flange. So here B suffix F value is 16.8 into TF. So I substitute this value in this equation. So 16.8 into TF into TF. I am considering this as 1. So after taking this, I am substituting this value in equation 1. This AF value. AF value is already we having this. So I got thickness of the flange is 33.3 mm. So I am taking as 40 mm plates. So after calculating this, I mean section of flange, we need to provide width of the plate required. That is 18.628. That is area of the flange required by 40. So 40 is nothing but which we selected now. That is 40 mm plates thickness of the flange. So I got 465.7. After that, we use 480 mm by 40 mm thick plates. Here, this is the diagram. This is the plate girder. So 480 mm is the flange length, and this one is thickness 40 mm. And this is the web portion, which is 1000 mm and 16 mm thickness. And next, same flange. After that, we need to calculate the moment capacity of the girder. In page number 53, class number 8.2.1.2, IS 800-2007, the code is specifying this formula. Md equal to ZpFy by gamma m naught. So by calculating this, nothing but a plastic section modulus Zp value, we need to find out for this. Here I will show you 40 into 480, that is this one, 40 into 480 into 250 is the yield stress and 1040. So 1040 is nothing but from here to here length. So this total length is 1000 plus this 40. So 1040 divided by gamma m naught is partial safety factor value. In table number 5, this is available. So I got this value. After that, we need to calculate moment of inertia. So moment of inertia formula, we know that IZZ value, we know that BD cube by 12 plus A into YC square. But here the 2 is, here 2 flanges are there. We are doing both sides. So that's why I wrote it as 2. So B value 480 and D value is 40 cube by 12. Okay. Later on plus AYC square. A is nothing but area, that is 480 into 40 L into B, 480 into 40 into YC square, nothing but centroid. So here centroid, nothing but half of this portion. Half of this portion is nothing but 1000 plus 2 into 40 square, YC square. So 1000 is, this total distance is 1000 plus 2 into YC square plus 2 into this 40 plus 40. 2 times. So 2 into 40 whole square. Divided by, we need centroid means half of the distance. That's why I'm dividing with 2. So I got IZZ value as this one. After calculating this IZZ, we need to calculate, in code, the clause is given, that is 1.2 into IZZ by Ymax. So 1.2 into IZZ value, we know that by Ymax. Ymax is nothing but half of that portion. So here, total distance is 1080. So half of this 1080 is 540. So I wrote it as 540. So I got this value. After calculating this, I am writing this MD value, that is 4538.182 into 10 power 6 Newton meter, which is greater than the given moment. So hence it is okay, because the moment carrying capacity is which we got the value is 4538.182, and the moment value is already we calculated in the first step, that is 4233.6. So our strength is more, our capacity of the girder is more moment capacity than our moment. Hence it is okay. After that, we need to calculate shear resistance of the web. So in page number 59, the code is specifying that VD equal to VN by gamma m naught and VN equal to VP, that is shear resistance. So VP formula is AV Fy by gamma m naught into root 3. So AV is nothing but area. So area is D into T, thickness of the web into depth. So into Fy gamma m naught root 3. I substitute all the values. This is 1000 and this is 16 mm and this is 250 yield stress divided by gamma m naught is 1.1 into root 3. After calculating that, I got 2000 change value. So our shear force is already first we calculated, that is 705.6 kilonewtons. Okay, here our capacity is 2099.455, so greater than our shear force, hence it is okay. Next, check for end bearing. For this, in page number 67, the code is specifying that the formula for end bearing, B1 plus N2 into TW Fy by gamma M0. So by using the this formula, we are going to calculate the end bearing. So here N2 is nothing but 2.5 into flange thickness, which is specified by code. You can refer the code book IS 800 2007, in page number 67 this clause is mentioned. So 2.5 times the flange thickness, that is 100 mm I got. And B1 is nothing but minimum stiff bearing. So minimum stiff bearing you will just assuming as 100 mm. Okay, and after that I'm substituting all the values in FW. So I got 727 kilonewtons, which is greater than our shear force, hence it is also okay. After that, design of weld connection. Now we are going to connect by using welding, web plate and flange plate. So here, shear stress in flange at the level of junction, web and flange, that is nothing but here junctions are there. So this is one junction and this is another junction. This is web portion and this is, these two are flange portions. So here Q equal to F by BI into A into Y bar. So F is nothing but shear force, we know that. And next B is 480 into, that is I value we calculated, 2 into 560 1.28 into 10 power 6. And A is nothing but area, L into B, 480 into 40 into Y bar. Y bar is nothing but centroid. That is half of the depth distance is 500 plus 40 by 2. So I got Q equal to 0.512 Newton per mm square. Next, shear force per mm length in the junction. So total length of the junction is 480. So 0.512 into 480, 245.76 Newtons. After calculating that, we need to provide the size of the weld. So size of the weld formula is, let S be the size of the weld, and throat thickness formula we know that 0.7 into S, which is specified in welding class. So providing weld on both sides of web strength per unit length. So here 2 into, so both sides 2, 0.7 into S, that is throat thickness, and Fu by root 3 into 1 by gamma ml. So I got 265.1 S. So here after calculating this, we need to calculate S value. So equating shear force, I am equating 265.1 S is equal to 245.76, which we got the value here, this one. So by equating S, I got 0.92 mm, but the code is specifying that we need to provide 5 mm minimum weld. As per table 21, the code is specifying that we need to provide 5 mm minimum weld. So that's why I'm providing 5 mm, since the thickness of the web is 16 mm. So for calculating the weld length, I got 0.92 by 5 mm minimum into 100, 18.4. So after that, by using use for 40 mm long welds with a gap of 160 mm, which satisfies the clauses. That is, the first clause is minimum weld length is 40 mm and maximum unwelded length is 12 into 16. So this is the 16 or 920 mm. Ultimately, our final design is web, that is 1000 by 16 mm, flange 480 into 40 mm, 480 by 40 mm, and weld is 5 mm. Like this, we are going to design the plate girder in design of steel structures. One thing here in this problem, we are not providing any stiffeners, that is intermediate stiffeners and end stiffeners, because in this problem we are avoiding the intermediate stiffness and end stiffeners. That's why we didn't calculate the stiffeners. In the next video, I'll upload by using stiffeners how we are going to design the plate girder. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.